Hello, I'm Ty Mason of the diabetescouncil.com, researcher, writer, and I have type 2 diabetes. I want to emphasize that my perspective is coming from one with type 2 and not type 1 diabetes. Our channel is primarily for those with type 2 diabetes and pre-diabetes. Today, I want to answer the question, what do diabetes medications do to my body? After you watch the video today, I invite you to check out the description box for my new ebook. This is one of the most comprehensive diabetes meal planning books you'll find anywhere. It contains diabetes-friendly meals and recipes, recipes for different goals, such as 800 to 1800 calories per day meal plans, diabetes meal planning tips and tricks. There are also tons of diabetes-friendly recipes for everyone. For those of you with pre-diabetes, you may or may not be taking meds. In another video, I discovered that even though the American Diabetes Association recommends metformin for those with pre-diabetes, only about 10% or less was actually prescribed the drug. Some of you may not be taking any diabetes medication, while others may be taking metformin and even insulin of some sort. So I will try to give you a brief overview thanks to my friends from the United Kingdom Diabetes Association who has done extensive studies on this topic. Metformin contains the active ingredient metformin hydrochloride. Metformin is available both in combination with other drugs or as a single treatment therapy, a monotherapy. Metformin was approved in the United States for use in 1994. Now, metformin helps those with diabetes to respond normally to insulin. Like most diabetic drugs, the ultimate goals of metformin are to lower blood sugar to a normal level and maintain this level. Metformin can be used in conjunction with other diabetic drugs, and those with diabetes should also use diet and exercise to help control their condition. Metformin helps the body to control blood sugar in several ways. The drug helps type 2 diabetes respond better to their own insulin, lowers the amount of sugar created by the liver, and decreases the amount of sugar absorbed in the intestines. There are other diabetic drugs, but for those of you with pre-diabetes or even type 2, I suspect metformin is what you might be taking if you're taking anything. Now, a quick word about insulin. Even those very few with diabetes will be taking insulin, I think it's worth giving a brief overview because in the chance that your diabetes or pre-diabetes turns into type 2, you'll need to know about it. Those of you with type 2 who take insulin, well, this may give you some insight as to what it does and how it works. You see, insulin is a hormone and it's made in your pancreas. That's a gland located behind your stomach. It allows your body to use glucose for energy. Glucose is a type of sugar found in many carbs. After a meal or a snack, the digestive tract breaks down carbohydrates and changes them into glucose. Glucose is then absorbed into your bloodstream through the lining of your small intestine. Once glucose is in your bloodstream, insulin causes cells throughout your body to absorb the sugar and use it for energy. Insulin also helps balance your blood glucose levels. When there's too much glucose in your bloodstream, insulin signals your body to store the excess in your liver. The stored glucose isn't released until your blood glucose levels decrease, such as between meals or when your body is stressed or is in need of an extra boost of energy. People with diabetes either don't make enough insulin or your body doesn't use it properly. That is where insulin injections come into play. Insulin injections simply replace or supplement your body's supply of insulin. All types of insulin produce the same effect. The makeup of different types of insulin affects how fast and how long they will work to help mimic the natural increases and decreases of insulin levels throughout your body during the day. There is a rapid-acting insulin. This type of insulin begins working approximately 15 minutes after injection. Its effects can last between 2 and 4 hours, and it's often used between or before a meal. Short-acting insulin. You inject this insulin before a meal. It starts working 30 minutes or maybe an hour after you inject it, and it lasts 5 to 8 hours. Intermediate acting insulin. This type of insulin starts working in 30 minutes to an hour after injection, and it may last up to 8 hours. And then there's long acting insulin. This insulin may not start working until about 2 hours after you inject it, but it lasts up to 24 hours. I hope this video has been informative for you concerning how those diabetes meds can affect your body. Don't forget to get my new ebook, and please subscribe to our channel for many more videos like this one in the future. Thank you so much for watching. I'm Ty Mason.